So another topic is there in that MOSFET is scaling. So we already know that once the time is rapidly moving, based on that, the transistor sizing is also reducing very rapidly. Like few years back, it was working on 250 nanometer. Now they are working on around 2.5 nanometer. So there has been a very rapid change between the device sizing. This change, what is the need of this change? So why we are going for MOSFET scaling? So the MOSFET scaling need is based on the current requirement. Like everyone needs a mobile phone, and that mobile phone should be such that it should be a portable, like it can be adjusted into the pocket and we can take it to from one place to another. So based on that, so as the requirement increases, there was the need of MOSFET scaling. So this MOSFET scaling, what finally it does is it increases the density of a chip. So once the MOSFET is scaled, means कोई भी ट्रांजिस्टर है अगर उसको वन सेंटीमीटर वन स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर चिप है उसको वन सेंटीमीटर वन स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर का स्पेस एरिया चाहिए होता है. सो इफ वी हैव वी आर रिड्यूसिंग द ट्रांजिस्टर ओके अगर हम चिप के ट्रांजिस्टर को रिड्यूस करें देन उसके साइज को हम रिड्यूस कर सकते हैं. सो बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ हाई डेंसिटी चिप वी वर वेंट फॉर MOSFET स्केलिंग. ओके सो इन दिस MOSFET स्केलिंग दिस इन दिस topic we will be basically studying the MOSFET scaling along with what is the effect of this MOSFET scaling. So this MOSFET scaling effects are called small geometry effect. Okay, so once we will be scaling MOSFET to get our desired high density and high performance chip, and in addition to this high addition chip that we will be getting some effects also. This effects will be called as small geometry effect. So once we are making a transistor small, so there are some ill effects or unwanted effects will be there on that transistor operation. That transistor operation ill effect will be studied under the small geometry effect. Okay, so how these small geometry effects will be affecting the performance parameters, we will be studying one by one. So first of all, we will see that how the scaling of MOSFETs takes place. Okay, so basically the scaling of MOSFET takes place with respect to two methods. The first one is constant field scaling, that is also called as full scaling. Okay, and another one is constant voltage scaling. So there are basically two types of methods through which we can reduce the transistor sizes. So that is constant field and constant voltage scaling. So while scaling, we will be assuming a parameter that is called scaling factor. Okay, so this is called the scaling factor, and this scaling factor will be represented by S, and S will always be greater than 1. Okay, greater than 1 hai, that means कोई भी dimension है अगर वो 2 centimeter का है तो हमें अगर इसको scale करना है तो हम कोई बड़े वैल्यू से एक से बड़े वैल्यू से कुछ इसको 5 से अगर हम स्केल करना है तो 5 से डिवाइड कर देंगे तो जो ये नेक्स्ट वैल्यू आएगी दैट विल बी लेस देन 2. ठीक है, ये वैल्यू लेस देन 2 से छोटी होगी. सो इफ वी आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस 2 वी नीड टू डिवाइड इट बाई अ लार्जर वैल्यू दैट शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 1. एक से ज़्यादा किसी भी वैल्यू से हम डिवाइड करेंगे देन द ऑब्टेंड वैल्यू विल ऑलवेज बी लेस देन 2. ओके, तो सेम वैसे ही हम स्केलिंग फैक्टर एस को लेते हैं एंड दैट्स एस विल बी ग्रेटर देन 1 ऑलवेज. ठीक है, सो वी विल बी टेकिंग कंसिडरिंग दिस. सो सपोज कोई एरिया है, सो एरिया अगर फाइंड आउट करना है तो एरिया का एक क्या होता है एक्सप्रेशन, कोई लेंथ होगा और कोई वेड्थ होगा, इसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे दैट विल बी इक्वल्स टू एरिया. तो सपोज वी आर रिड्यूसिंग लेंथ बाय एस. ठीक है, अगर हम एस से रिड्यूस कर रहे हैं और विड्थ को भी एस से रिड्यूस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, जो हमारा फाइनल जो एरिया आएगा दैट विल बी रिड्यूस्ड बाय पैरामीटर लाइक एस स्क्वायर. दैट मीन्स एरिया जो है हमारा वो एस स्क्वायर से रिड्यूस हो गया. ठीक है, सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन find out the effect at how the scaling will affect the performance parameter. So अगर हम channel length और width को reduce करते हैं s से, तो उसका area जो होगा वो s square से reduce होगा, ठीक है? There will be a more efficient with respect to a density of a chip. And this scaling factor we say like the scaling of the chip or the scaling of the transistor or the scaling of a technology. Okay, so based on the technology, the how a new technology is taking place, that can be based on the scaling of a device. This can be considered like it always reduces after every 2 or 3 years. Okay. That means if a new generation of manufacturing technology replaces the previous one for every 2 to 3 years. दो या तीन साल के अंदर एक नया टेक्नोलॉजी आ जाता है. That is the point. And here the downscaling factor S is about 1.2 to 1.5. That means कोई भी टेक्नोलॉजी है, कोई भी ट्रांजिस्टर है, वो अराउंड 1.2 से 1.5 टाइम्स स्केल हो जाता है आफ्टर एवरी 2 to 3 ईयर्स. ओके, सो वी विल सी लाइक वन मोर थिंग. सो दिस इज द स्केलिंग ऑफ डिवाइसेस बेस्ड ऑन द ईयर्स. लाइक इन 1985 द फीचर साइज. सो व्हाट इज फीचर साइज? सो फीचर साइज इज द मिनिमम डायमेंशन दैट कैन बी डिफाइंड एंड मैन्युफैक्चर्ड ऑन अ चिप. So this is the minimum size of a transistor that can be defined and can be manufactured on a chip that will be considered as the feature size. So in 1985, the feature size was 2.5 micrometer. Okay, so this was the feature size in 1985, and it goes like in 1999, the feature size remains 0.25. Okay, so there were based on the scaling trend, it has been observed like in every 2 to 3 years it got scaled by 1.2 to 1.5 times, or it also being governed by the Moore's law. You might have known Moore's law, we call it Moore's law. So in that Moore's law, every transistors, the density of a transistor, density of a chip almost doubles. So it got two times, it becomes two times for every 18 months. Okay, so after every 18 months the density of a chip gets doubled. Okay, so this is your Moore's law. So you might have studied in other courses also. So this is how the scaling takes place. Suppose this is the MOSFET and this is the channel length. So channel length, the new channel length like L dash will be equals to L by S, that is scaled by S parameter. Again the length TOX, that is oxide thickness, will be reduced by 1 by S. So TOX, the new oxide thickness will be TOX divided by S. And whatever dimensions or whatever length will be there, that will always be reduced by 1 by S. Okay, so that means it will be having 1 by S scaling factor. Okay, it is being scaled by 1 by S, whatever length will be there. But with respect to that, we can consider like doping. So doping is increased by S, here the doping is increased by S, here the doping is increased by S. So we will see that how or why we are increasing the doping, we will see later. So this is how it will look like if we are going to scale a MOS device. So in the full scaling or the scaling called constant field scaling. So we know that scaling is of two types, like constant field and constant voltage. So as the name suggests, it is constant field. That means we will be scaling the MOSFET so that the electric field in the channel region or the oxide region will be constant. Okay, so electric field will be constant. So electric field will be constant, but in that the voltages, whatever voltages will be there, like gate voltage, drain to source voltage, threshold voltage, all voltages will be scaled. So after scaling, in the constant field scaling method, the channel length L will become L dash is equals to L by S. Similar to this, the whatever length dimensions will be there, okay, that dimensions will be always reduced by 1 by S. Okay, so the new dimension will be L by S, W by S, outside thickness will be TUX divided by S. Junction depth, this junction depth indicates how much is the width of depletion layer. Depletion layer width from the channel is given by junction depth. So it is XJ divided by S. And then whatever supply voltages will be there. So these are the dimensions and these are the voltages. So whatever voltages will be there, that will be reduced by 1 by S also. So in case of constant field scaling, the voltages will be reduced. Okay. And in the doping concentration case, this is doping. Okay. So in this doping concentration case, so what happens? It is of constant field scaling. Okay. So once the electric field is always given by, electric field is given by voltage divided by L. Okay, length is there. So this voltage is there. Okay, so once we are reducing the voltage, okay, so this the voltage is being reduced, then to compensate this electric field to be constant, we should be increasing the doping densities. ठीक है, क्योंकि हम voltage को scale कर रहे हैं, then to maintain the constant field, that is constant electric field, we should be having a doping concentration that should be doped with S into Na. That means S times the doping concentration should be increased so that the constant field can be obtained inside the oxide region or the channel region. Okay, so that you need to keep in mind, like in constant field, that is constant electric field scaling, the voltages should be scaled by 1 by S, but the doping concentration should be increased by S parameter, the S factor. Okay, so once we know the doping profile, like this should be the doping structure of a MOS device, based on that we should be finding like what should be the current in the linear region and what should be the current in the saturation region. We will find one by one. So from there, if channel length and width are doped by like that, and oxide thickness is given by 1 by S, so from there the oxide, this was oxide thickness. Based on oxide thickness, the oxide capacitance is defined. This oxide capacitance is given by epsilon OX divided by TOX. If TOX is divided by scaled by 1 by S parameter, so this S parameter will be comes to the front side, and it will be S into COX. So this will be the here the new oxide thickness. The new oxide thickness will be scaling by directly by S parameter, S factor. Okay, so it will be S into COX. And also the aspect ratio, that is this term W by L, is given by the term called aspect ratio. W by L का जो ratio है हम उसको बोलते हैं aspect ratio. ठीक है, ये ध्यान देना. कहीं भी अगर aspect ratio लिखा हो, कि अगर find out करें कि किसी transistor का aspect ratio find out करना है, that means we need to find out the W by L ratio. So once by finding the length and width, we can find out the aspect ratio. So aspect ratio will be unchanged because W and L both are being scaled by 1 by S, so its ratio will remain change, will remain unchanged. And from there we can find like Kn. So this Kn will be scaled by a factor of S. Okay, so because mu n, whatever mu n is there, that is mobility. So mobility is unaffected by this scaling in case of constant field scaling. Clearly considering no effect on this mobility, so Kn will be scaled by S directly in S factor. So from there we can find like how the current can be scaled and how power can be scaled. So current we can find after putting the all values, scale values, we can find like the ID in the linear region should be scaled by 1 by S, and similarly the ID in saturation is also scaled by 1 by S. Okay, that means overall we can say the current in the constant field scaling will be reduced by 1 by S parameter. Okay, and so from there the P, that is our power, will be given by ID into VDS. Okay, ID into VDS will be given by the power. So this power will be reduced by, like, ID is 1 by S. So ID will be given by 1 by S, and VDS is also reduced by 1 by S. So overall, the power will be reduced by S square. Okay. So here, once we are going to scale the transistor in constant field scaling, the power will be reduced by S square parameter. So there will be a very less power dissipation once the power once we are going for scaling a transistor. Okay. So we can see some a significant reduction in power mostly, but the power density, if we will find out the power density, the how power density is going to be affected, will after the power density, it will be like the power density per unit area remaining virtually unchanged. So this conclusion is given in this table. So oxide capacitance will be reduced directly by S parameter, increased by S parameter. So ID will be reduced by 1 by S. Power dissipation will be reduced by 1 by S square, but the power density will be power divided by area. This will remain unchanged. So per density, per unit area, whatever the power dissipation will be divided there, that will be unchanged. So these are the different parameters that how constant field scaling will be affecting. So next we will see that how constant voltage scaling affects the transistor performance. So in case of constant voltage, so as the name suggests, constant voltage means in the previous one, yes, we were also scaling the voltage. So these are the voltages we are scaling by 1 by S. But in case of constant voltage, the voltages will not be scaled. Means whatever voltages are there, these get to source, or whatever voltages are there, that will remain a constant value. So it will not be scaled. So based on that, once we find out the same similar to that, we will be finding the ID and ID linear and ID saturation. We can see from there, like, it is having S into ID linear and similarly S into ID saturation. And with respect to that, we will calculate the power. So from there, we can see, like, in case of constant voltage scaling, the power is increased by S factor. Okay. So, but in case of previous one, constant field scaling, the power were reduced by 1 by S square parameter. Okay. But in case of constant voltage scaling, the power is being increased. Okay. So power is being increased. But if we find out the power density, from there we can find, like, the S square, this was being scaled by S times, but again the power density is scaled by S cube times. That means power will be very high once we are reducing the sizes with respect to constant voltage. ठीक है, so constant voltage के term में क्या है, अगर constant voltage method हम apply करते हैं scaling के लिए, तो वहाँ पे scaling के बाद power dissipation बहुत ही ज़्यादा बढ़ जा रहा है. ठीक है, okay, so this was the disadvantage of this constant voltage scaling, but there are some advantages also. So what happens in practical, we can say, like, in practical cases, we use this constant voltage scaling is preferred over the full scaling or the constant field scaling, because in constant field scaling उसमें क्या हो रहा था कि हम वोल्टेज को भी स्केल कर रहे थे. अगर हम डिवाइस को स्केल करेंगे तो विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दैट हम वोल्टेज को भी स्केल करेंगे. बट समटाइम्स क्या होता है कि कोई भी सर्किट हम इम्प्लीमेंट कर रहे हैं तो वोल्टेज की वैल्यू फिक्स होती है. लाइक कोई भी सर्किट है, उसको वर्क करने के लिए 5 वोल्ट चाहिए ही चाहिए. अगर उससे कम अगर हम करेंगे तो सर्किट वर्क नहीं करेगा, ऑपरेट नहीं करेगा. ठीक है, तो ऐसे केसेस में कॉन्स्टेंट फील्ड स्केलिंग वर्क नहीं करेगा. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर हम कॉन्स्टेंट फील्ड स्केलिंग अगर अप्लाई करेंगे तो वो वोल्टेज का जो लेवल है वो भी स्केल कर देगा, तो वो सर्किट ऑपरेट नहीं करेगी. ठीक है, so to avoid that condition, what we do is practically we should be using constant voltage scaling. Okay, so in constant voltage scaling, the voltage levels, that is voltage nodes of a circuit, will remain constant, and all other parameters, that is dimensions, will be reduced. So this in spite of it is having high power dissipation, if we are reducing the device, then also we will be using the constant voltage scaling only. Okay, so because of that disadvantage in case of constant field scaling, so it also reduces the intermediate node voltages also. So that can cause a problem to the circuit operation. So we will be basically using the constant voltage scaling in the practical cases. So there are some disadvantages of this constant voltage scaling method. So here, increasing current density and power density. So here, current density and power density, we can see like the power density is being increased by S cube times, and also the current density we find. So current was increased by S times, but current density will be increased by S cube times. Current density and power density is being increased. This is the disadvantage of your constant voltage scaling. And also because of this electromigration, hot carrier degradation, oxide breakdown, and electric overstress will be taking place. So these terms we will be using studying in the small geometry effect. So small geometry effect, jo bhi hai, small channel effect, jo bhi hai. हम उसमें इन टर्म्स को पढ़ेंगे. सो दीज आर द डिसएडवांटेज ऑल्सो सर, लाइक दीज आर द इफेक्ट दैट वी विल बी फाइंडिंग आउट इन केस ऑफ वी आर यूजिंग कॉन्स्टेंट वोल्टेज स्केलिंग. ओके, सो वी नीड टू रिमूव दिस डिसएडवांटेज, सो दैट वी विल स्टडी इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. ठीक है, कुछ समझ में आया? ठीक है क्लास? हाँ ठीक है, ओके थैंक यू. सो क्लोज करेंगे अब, और किसी को कोई डाउट है तो आप तो किसी को डाउट है.